the most amazing things about this Poshfest is
Poshmark has allowed me the ability to prove my stupid fiance wrong for not believing that I could do this as a full-time job. Oh, how wrong he was.
I Posh because I love to travel, and what I'm earning on Poshmark helps me pay for my travel expenses.
Absolutely. Can
we re-queue the video,
it's
please?
It's like one of my favorite hobbies in the whole world. So who wouldn't like
guys,
to do
can we re-queue the video?
And make money doing it.
When I was part-time, they paid off my student loans. I was able to completely do that with Poshmark funds, which is amazing. It's so nice to be debt-free. But also, Poshmark is now my full-time job.
We have an amazing video curated from all of you that we want to share with you first.
It's horrible enough, so I couldn't work majority of the time.
Recently decided that I wanted to go back to school. I Posh because it helps me maintain a flexible schedule so that I can handle daily life, studying, and it also allows me to pay my bills.
It helps with money because I'm a college student.
It helps pay for my children's extra educational opportunities.
Really gets me excited about reselling in a way no other platform does.
Poshmark has allowed me the ability to prove my stupid fiance wrong for not believing that I could do this as a full-time job. Oh, how wrong he was.
I Posh because I love to travel, and what I'm earning on Poshmark helps me pay for my travel expenses.
Absolutely love to thrift. It's like one of my favorite hobbies in the whole world. So who wouldn't like to do what they love to do and make money doing it?
When I was part-time, they paid off my student loans. I was able to completely do that with Poshmark funds, which is amazing. It's so nice to be debt-free. But also, Poshmark is now my full-time job, so they pay all of my bills.
I had the opportunity to meet new people, and I can style and dress for a fraction of the price.
I used to have a long career in traditional retail, and with Poshmark, I'm able to do retail my way while being completely available for my kids.
I actually love it. It's not, like something I force myself to do.
I'm a two-time breast cancer survivor, and going through cancer and chemo, that's horrible enough. So I couldn't work majority of the time. Poshmark gave me the opportunity to work from home and sell some of my stuff and make some cash.
I've been diagnosed with pyorrhea malformation, a rare brain disorder that has made it really hard for me to find a stable job. But with Poshmark, I've been able to make an income right from the comfort of my own home, and I don't have to worry about if my symptoms cause me to miss a day of work or not.
Posh is a community of thriving, self-made Posh bosses.
It's so special because it allows men and women from all walks of life to come together and share this amazing passion.
The level of engagement is unbelievable.
You feel connected.
So inspiring, so motivating, so encouraging.
They Posh for the environment. I Posh for the environment.
They were there for me when I needed to find my wedding dress last minute. That's for darn sure.
And the users are super friendly. They always reach out if you need support or just want to be friends.
I've met so many amazing people who have taught me new things and been able to help me grow my business.
Posh community is weird, the good kind of weird.
Each closet has items that represent the seller's sense of style.
Because Poshmark has this wonderful community, it has allowed me to share and network with other Poshers while we can help each other.
It's more about team building and helping to elevate one another rather than compete.
I'm very proud to be a member of such supportive and wonderful community.
I got into Poshmark last year when I came down with breast cancer. I've made some good friends. They're very supportive of my condition. And thank you so much for making a difference and helping me get through my 8 months of recovery with a smile. I want you to know that I'm a survivor of breast cancer and I love Poshmark. Together.
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 We Posh.
We Posh.
We Posh.
Together. We Posh.
Together. We Posh.
Together. We Posh.
So let's try this another time. This is our seventh PoshFest. We have had six before this. Can I have everyone who's attended the very first PoshFest stand up? Let's give these guys a big hand. They didn't know what they were signing up for. We didn't know what we were doing. But they pioneered in terms of what PoshFest should be about. And it's been getting better every year. And I think this is an incredible PoshFest. If you just look around, there's 1,600 of you in this room. That is, in 7 years, PoshFest has grown almost 14-fold, 14 times. That many people have committed to travel from across the country, share their passion, grow with each other, commit to each other. But let's take a second here and just turn around. Look at each other. I think the morning needs to start with just one thing, which is what I feel about all of you, which is gratitude. Thank you. If you can turn around and find someone and please thank them for a second. We would not be here without all of you. You would not be here without everyone who's sitting around us, because number one, Poshmark is a community. It is a community of people who've chosen to take a journey together. And that journey starts with fashion, but it doesn't really end with fashion. It ends with a tremendous amount of love, shared passion that we create, that we are connected, that we sort of embrace each other. We embrace each other for who we are, exactly who we are. We don't have to be different. You could have a fashion sense which is all luxury. You could have a fashion sense which is all quirky, and it really doesn't matter. If you look around, you'll find people who are just like you, who are exactly connected to you, but each of us is different. It isn't just we are different from the outside. We're also different from the inside. And that's what makes us special, is that there is no judgment. You're all welcome here. Everyone comes from a different journey, different background. Not just how we look, not just sort of who we are, not just the gender identity we carry, but also the ages we are, from where we've come, how we think about the world. It's all very different. And if you look around, you'll see people who are in their 70s. I met someone who was 16-year-old who's come here. This is our first PoshFest where I think the number of men attending the PoshFest is exactly the attendance counts, or close to the attendance counts, of just the total number of Poshes we had attending the very first PoshFest. So it's just amazing. Let's welcome all the men in the audience. And now with home category, we also have different things available that everyone can shop for. As we grow and move together, it is as much about supporting each other in Poshmark as it is about just taking your own journey. And this journey today, the next 2 days, is a journey of growth. Each of you have come here to grow in a different way. Connect, share, and then grow. We're here, we've been growing, and to grow, each one of us needs to evolve, right? But to evolve, we need the support of people around us. So one of the things I would like each of you to do today is not only identify how you want to grow, and don't just think about it, write it on your iPhone, but more importantly, if you write it on a piece of paper, it'll actually manifest in its growth. But the second thing you can do is, if you meet a stranger, first of all, don't be shy. Everyone feels strange inside. Make sure that you connect with them and ask them, how can you help them grow? So it isn't just about your growth, it is also about supporting everyone else's growth today and for the next few days and for the next year. That's how our community grows. And ultimately, that's how we have grown. We haven't grown without you. You've given us feedback. I remember in the very first PoshFest, we sat down in a circle and we talked about, there were so many things missing. We didn't have a single shipping label. We didn't have a way to easily ship. We didn't have so many different things. There was no offers. People would leave comment. They would negotiate in public. Just so many things that came after that that really made Poshmark a better place to be. And there will be so many things we'll talk about that are going to come in the future that continue to hopefully make it a more welcome, more amazing place for everyone to shop from and sell. And so the only way we can grow is together. And that's really the key and the key theme for these next 2 days for all of us. Well, what has happened in the last couple of years? we all started on this journey 7-8 years back. We knew that retail is changing. We knew that we don't want to bury our clothes in the ground. We knew that we hardly use our clothes. We also knew that everyone wants access to everything. Well, in the last 7 years, not only have we changed retail, each of you has gone out and reinvented retail in such a big, dramatic way. You have created your own fashion brands. You've been able to recover stuff that people might have discarded and elevated it. You've transformed retail in so many different things. However, in the last year, the world is starting to recognize fast fashion is no longer in fashion. Really, where each of us is trying to go is to make fashion everlasting, but not everlasting just on ourselves, but by sharing it with all of us. We are creating new brands that are, just have a very different point of view in terms of what we are trying to do. It isn't about saying, oh, everyone needs to look a certain shape or size or a certain color, a certain way. We're changing that perspective. We have men who are jumping into fashion in their own way. Different people who are sort of maybe don't even identify in a specific way are coming in and saying, you know, hey, let's embrace fashion in a new way. And that retail revolution is being created by all of you, by each and every one of you, as you think, you do, you act, and you create. And so where are we going with that? There's really a massive amount of opportunity. The opportunity is in really taking what people have worn before and reselling it. It's about creating new original art and design. It's around partnering with fashion brands in unique ways. We have 150 unique brands that have been created just on Poshmark alone. And there's more to come. Each of you, with your own closet name, is a brand. People are not buying just a specific, you know, Gucci or whatever. They're buying it from you, and their affiliation is with you, and you are a brand to many of your shoppers. So brand, the notion of a brand is changing. When you start to accumulate those followers and grow, those people are connected to you. They're not connected just to the items you're carrying, they're connected to you. And that is the new retail revolution. New retail revolution is actually like the old retail revolution. It's personal. When we used to go into a store 50 years back, the retailer would know us by name. They would know what we are shopping for. They would know what we care about. That's what each of you do. You know your shoppers by name. You may even know the name of their kids. Where in the world do you find that? Let's give ourselves a big hand, all of you, in terms of the deep connections you're creating, and that is really the new retail revolution. It isn't just about sustainability. It isn't just about fashion. It's about people. And that's really what we are going to celebrate. We have 50 million people in our community today. 50 million people. And that is just in the United States. People are connected, they're spending an enormous amount of time on the platform, they're engaging, they're talking, they're conversing, but more importantly, they're selling. We have 7 million sellers on the platform. 7 million sellers, just take a minute and think about it. Now, there's two ways you can think about it. You can think about it, there's 7 million sellers. Oh gosh, there's 7 million sellers. How am I gonna sell anything, right? But then if you turn around and look at your closet and think of how much you buy, then you realize that there's a lot of room for expansion. Fashion, clothing, home is almost an unlimited opportunity. It's an infinite opportunity. It's not a zero-sum game. The more people who join the movement, the more people who join the platform, the more we come together, the bigger we all become together. And ultimately, selling allows people to make room in their closet, which allows most people to sort of then go forward. And then for some people who really find this to be their vocation, they rise up and they make it their business. And for some people who get more passionate, they can create their own fashion brand, and you can keep going, because in growth lies true happiness. When we are growing, we feel happy. And for each of us, the journey of growth is distinct. The journey of growth for me will be very different than you. That'll be very different than someone else. And so as you go through each of these journeys, what you will find is that each point, when you feel stalled, when you feel like you're not going to be moving forward, you're not growing. And so for each of these 7 million sellers, they are taking a very specific journey, just like you are taking a very specific journey. And why is that journey so unique? It is unique because each of us is unique. And that plays into one of our core principles as a company, which is embrace your weirdness. Who here feels strange? I do. Everyone does. Does that make us all strange? No. That means strangeness is actually not strange. So what that means is that do not try to imitate. You can get inspired by other people, but follow your own journey. It sounds like a platitude, it sounds so boring, but it's actually true. The more people who join, the more you sort of double down on your own journey, the better you become. And for us as a company, that has been about doubling down on our single bet that we started, which is empowering people. And everything we do is focused on that and keeping everything else super simple on the platform. Now, one of the unique things about Poshmark is sharing. Who shared in the last hour? And if you didn't, why not? You are together sharing 30 million items. That's roughly 350 shares per second. Now, if you think about it, what is sharing and why did we invent sharing? Not to tire out your fingers. We're not masochists. But it's really to give everyone a fair chance at discovery. What does that mean? If I gave you promoted listings, then the only people who pay will get their inventory exposed. What sharing does is it normalizes the world. A new seller has as much chance of getting exposed as a veteran seller. Now, we'll be looking at how do we scale sharing as you build out big closets. You have tens of thousands of listings. How do we sort of support that? But in general, it has worked out to be very well. The second thing sharing creates is serendipity. When I'm looking at shared items, I can discover things I did not even know existed. It also gives a way for smaller brands, unknown brands to shine, for new sellers and unknown brands to shine, because otherwise the big brands end up taking all of the energy in any kind of a shopping experience. So sharing is actually the great equalizer. And that is why it has been put with some friction, because it really allows you to participate in the broader Poshmark economy as a first-class citizen. Let's talk a little bit about what you guys have all done together. 7 million sellers growing. You are changing how retail is being structured. Last year, we announced that all of you had, from the beginning, delivered and earned over $1 billion. That was a pretty major milestone. You remember celebrating it last year? Well, just in the last year, just over a year since then, we have doubled that amount. You have all earned cumulative over $2 billion. What is even crazier is that there's more seller stylists on Poshmark than there are drivers in Uber, than there are hosts in Airbnb, than there are sellers on Etsy combined. And why is that happening? It's happening because simplicity is the key to success. You may not have a car, you may not want to drive a car, you may not have a room, but everyone has to wear clothes, at least today. There may be a day we don't, and we'll talk about that. But today we all have to wear clothes, and everyone has clothes, and those clothes create opportunity, not just for yourself, but for everyone around you. And that's why there's more of you, and I feel by end of next year, we will take this to a number that few could have imagined in terms of how many people can participate in the selling economy. Some sell to refresh, some sell to protect the environment, some sell to connect, but some sell to create new kinds of fashion and new kinds of brands. And really doesn't matter what your cause is, you're all selling and participating in this economy. Posh Markets. Posh Markets is something, an innovation we started last year. And tomorrow morning, you're gonna hear from Tracy and John in terms of the innovation we are doing there and what was sort of the rationale. But let me capture it for a second in terms of what is Posh Markets and why did we do that. At the first glance, Posh Markets seem like they're just categories. Why do you need a market for it? Why can't you just have a category? In some ways, you're right. But really, the heart of Posh Markets is really the heart of Poshmark, which is Posh Markets are about elevating communities of people who are passionate about selling, shopping, connecting around that topic. So when you go to a Posh Market, you actually find a specific group of sellers who are highlighted. from the group of Posh ambassadors who actually are specialists in that category. So it's a very good way to discover people and connect with people. It's also a great way to shop. And so we've launched over 30 or so Posh markets by now, and the most interesting way it allows us to do is it allows us to go into categories that are not just directly fashion related. And in that world, when we go into a category that's not just fashion related, you can either shop that category or you can stay in the fashion world or you can just be in that category. It allows you to have that very immersive experience. So most recently, we launched home. And it is just a joy to shop Poshmark Home. It's so beautifully curated. What you guys are curating there is just amazing. And it's given us the confidence that we are going to be able to open up new vistas and new ways in which we can scale that Poshmark. We just launched fine watches, and I didn't know there was $250,000 watch listed on Poshmark. Who knows that there's $250,000 watch listed on Poshmark? So I didn't know that till that market was launched, and it was kind of interesting to see that. So we have, you know, $5 items, and then I guess some people are selling $250,000 watches. So it is the whole gamut, you know, in terms of what Poshers are doing today. The other big thing that has been both exciting and challenging for Poshmark this year has been taking the first step outside United States. We talked about it last year, and it has happened. We launched Poshmark Canada on 1st of June, and it has been roughly about 4 months since we started that journey. In 4 months, the Canadian community has gone from zero Poshers to hundreds of thousands of Poshers. Amazing. And if you haven't connected to a few of those Canadian Poshers, just go to your Poshmarkets tab, switch to Canada, and meet and say hello to a few of them. They're your friends. They are part of your community. And what is interesting is that the reason that community is forming is that many of you are helping them, teach them how they should form and connect. And then they are starting to teach each other. There's, I think, close to 1,000 Posh ambassadors already created in Canada. And their requirements are very similar to Poshmark US. So they have to achieve all of those hurdles. And Canada, just in terms of total sales, has made as much progress in 4 months as it took us 18 to 20 months in the United States to create. So it is accelerating, and that gives us the confidence to start to think about the entire world and how do we sort of connect and create Poshmark communities and bring Poshmark love across the world. And as we think about the next few years, it'll be amazing to see Poshmark's community extending. Imagine if you're in a city, if you're in Milan, if you're in Sydney, if you're in Toronto, to be able to connect your local Poshers and attend a Posh and Sip there, how cool would that be? How amazing would that be? To be able to shop from them, to be able to connect with them, or even to just see what they have in their closets would be amazing. And it's going to be all one app, so you can always see it, just like with Canada. You can always shop, and you can always see what they are really wearing and what they are sharing. Let me switch from sort of where we've been to where we are going. And the journey ahead and thinking about sort of what we've done in the last 7-8 years and sort of what we are about to do is really recognizing two things. One is the amazing amount of feedback, energy, suggestions that we get from all of you. And we continue to factor that in. We have hackathon coming up, and you're going to see how some of the feedback is factoring into things that are being built. But the second thing is also to look at major waves of innovation that are happening. And one of the things that, you know, when we think about major waves of innovation that's happening is to think about a future that could be quite distinct than today. If you go back 10, 12 years, would everyone be staring at their phone all day? No. And today, how many of you are looking at your phone right now? Just fess up. So it's really changed. Many things we take for granted change. So we take for granted that we are wearing clothes. We're all building businesses on clothes. But let me give you an exercise. Think 10 years from today, and we're not wearing these colorful clothes that we are wearing. We just wake up, we put a light toga, and we go to work. But everyone still sees you in these beautiful clothes because we have little augmented reality chips that are projecting these clothes. How would your business transform that? What would you be doing to reinvent yourself for that new reality? And does that sound kind of a little crazy, a little Black Mirror-ish? But it actually could happen. Because think of what you're doing today. You're actually thinking that you have connecting to people when you're just connecting to them 100% through the mobile phone. How many people have met people here that they feel like are their closest friends, but you've actually never met in physical life? Please give it your hand. It's amazing, right? It's amazing the level of intimacy phone has brought into our life. So when we think about the journey ahead, we think about these major seismic things that can happen that will catch all of us by surprise, and how do you support that journey? And if you think that this whole sort of reality of augmented reality togas is crazy, well, think of something that we call Netflix and chill, right? And some of you might be old enough to remember that Netflix was not chill. You had to put those DVDs in an envelope. The DVDs would come. There was no chilling. It was a lot of work. Think of how that company adopted and created and recreated to something that is now binge watching, chilling, whatever, you know. And became much bigger. So I do believe that whatever the future holds, we're all going to be much bigger and much more interesting. So with that, let's talk a little bit about one of the first things we're going to talk about, artificial intelligence and machine learning. What the heck does that mean? And you're going to hear from some of the team who's working on some of these projects, but the goal of AI and machine learning is really to help each of you connect with your customers faster, to have the inventory you're posting get to the right group of people faster. We have the first project, which we internally call Olivia, that actually there's some user group and testing going on and many conversations happening. And that takes all the new inventory that's being posted and automatically matches it to new audiences, new customers, and connects them to these products. And that's based on their own shopping activities. So as you're posting inventory, it's getting transmitted, and it allows you to find new customers faster. That is based on some very deep data science and core work that the team has done, which can then be applied in so many different ways. Imagine if you visit a large closet and you could press a button and through data science and machine learning, it could find you the most interesting 20 items for you. How cool would that be? If you wanted to find the 30 or 40 Poshers who could be amazing partners and PFFs for you, this technology could help you. So it is all about, for us, it's all about bringing efficiency and learning to routine processes and building those deeper connections on the platform faster. So that's sort of where we are taking machine learning and artificial intelligence to, is in how to serve you in your closets and connect you to your audiences and connections faster. We have many more Posh markets coming up. There is going to be major category expansion in ways that you can visualize, think, and some you may not be able to really empower you to start to service even a broader ecosystem. When you think of fashion, it services a certain ecosystem. When we start to think of home decor, it services another ecosystem. But there's many people in your house. There are many things that we haven't started to service. For example, Fido, right? We've heard about that. How do we service them? Because they are very much part of our life. So you will see many things happening that will take Poshmark into new areas and allow each of you to service your customers new and unique ways. International shipping. This is something we've been working on. We want to make it super simple. Thank you. This is, again, we want to bring the Posh Post-like simplicity to it. We're working through it. And the first area you'll probably do it is US, Canada, because those are the countries we've connected. But ultimately, we want to make it very seamless so the clauses across the world are connected into a one universal Poshmark platform. And you can shop and ship anywhere. Of course, there's going to be different costs involved, but beyond that, you should be able to shop a closet in Japan, you should be able to shop a closet in Italy, and certainly one in Toronto. So that should be very, very exciting as that manifests itself. Video. Who's excited about video? So we've been working on something very exciting with video that's going to be talked about, and ultimately it empowers you in a very simple way to start to add video to how you tell your story about Poshmark. When we started the company, we kind of had one of these little slogans. We used to say, every closet has a story. Tell it, sell it. And I feel like with video coming together, we may be able to actually bring it all together. This is sort of my favorite innovation that's starting to happen. Who has heard or actually signed up to host a Posh and Sip Coffee Edition near Starbucks. Please stand up. Let's give these guys a big hand. We're bringing Posh and Sip to every Starbucks, hopefully with your help, across the country. And the goal is to really create a physical presence in every neighborhood, empower that neighborhood, teach people, not just people who are registered on the platform, but really activate them and use your power to build local communities, micro-local communities in your neighborhood around Starbucks. We've done some pilot programs. It's going to be powerful. There's 13,000 Starbucks, and I hope one day when you wake up at 10 o'clock in the morning, there's going to be 13,000 Starbucks get-together happening, hosted by our Posh teams across the country. And it's going to create a new wave of revolution, which isn't just about retail, it's about people. So that is something really powerful that is starting to happen. I think the first one rolls out in about a month. So please support. If you haven't signed up and you'd like to host, please sign up. And it's going to be really amazing. And the team has done a great job learning from stuff that is happening. There are going to be tons of Posh and Sips that are happening, but this is a very specific program that makes it very predictable to come at 10 o'clock on Saturday morning to your local Starbucks, and it'll be supported by the app. So the idea is that it becomes something that is a relatively non-intrusive time. It's in a very safe location, you don't need to know, and you can start to talk with strangers in a very comfortable way. As we sort of wrap up and we think about where we are going together, I would say, please remember the very first value that we have as a company and as a community, which is we start with love. We start with a connection. And we start with servicing someone. It's not about us as much as it is about the people we are servicing, the people we are loving. And if we do that consistently, rinse and repeat, as they say in the shampoo bottle, money will come. And it will come. But if you forget that, you may still have money, but money without love is kind of meaningless. So let's always remember as we move forward and we think about the next year, as we grow, as we connect, that our job is to serve people, is to help them. And through that process, we can create anything we want. So 2019 is wrapping up. 2020 is coming up. I would like, as you look at this conference, set up some ambitious goals for yourself. But set up those goals as for yourself, but also to serve others. And in that service lies true happiness. Thank you very much, and I really appreciate you guys hearing me out. There is one more thing. We have an amazing message for all of you, for someone we all deeply cherish and admire, someone who is the greatest of all times, who has chosen to take this journey with us. Let's hear from them.
Hey, to all my PFFs. Poshmark Fest, I wish I were there. I can't be there, unfortunately, but I just am having severe FOMO, and I wanted to make sure I said, welcome to PoshFest. I hope you have a great time. This is what Poshmark is all about, you entrepreneurs, you people out there that are just doing your own thing, and whether it's hustling like I do half the time or just believing in yourself. That's most important and that's key, is to believe in yourself and, you know, just make it work. So I'm really happy and proud of you guys. Again, I wish I could be there, but I can't. But continue the hard work, and I will continue to work hard for you at Poshmark. I look forward to seeing you all next year.
Let's all wish Serena is going to be here joining us next year. She has requested that we coordinate PoshFest days according to her schedule. So we hope that she shows up, and we will definitely accommodate that. Thank you very much.
How cool was that, you guys? That was amazing.
I have goosebumps, you guys. That was awesome.
Abiel and I were like wanting to cry backstage. Both Manish and Serena believe in all of you so much, as do we. So that was so exciting. There's so many exciting things to come.
So excited about our future.
So speaking of the future, it's almost lunchtime. Who's getting a little hungry? I can't believe the first portion of this day is almost half over. But before we break, we just have a few updates, announcements. Want to give you a little bit more lay of the land of what you can expect the rest of the day.
So settle in, listen up.
Yeah, so obviously meals are always going to take place right here in the main stage area. So hang tight. Just an update, we're going to do lunch by table numbers. So we're going to start with 1 through 40, but we'll give you a reminder at the end of the announcements. Also here on the third floor, we have two brand spanking new additions to PoshFest. First being our Posh Studio, which if you go out the door to your left, we would love to hear your stories, tips, tricks, how Poshmark has changed your life. So whether you want to come stop by yourself or with a group of PFFs and film yourself and say a few words, we would love that. Also, we have our Posh Markets pop-ups. Who's checked those out right here in the hallway? Really cool, right? We're bringing Posh Markets to life. We have our home market, luxury, activewear, and kicks. So definitely check those out. We're going to be doing giveaways, different activities. If you want to learn more about Posh Markets, definitely go check that out. Say hi to Team Posh over there. Lastly, on the third floor, we have our sponsors, and we want to give a shout out to our seventh year return sponsor, Andisha, who is our shipping partner. Give it up for Andisha. Makes it all possible. They're also going to be doing a scale giveaway, so visit the booth. Damon's awesome. Go check him out, and we'll be announcing a winner probably tomorrow, but you can have a chance to win a scale.
And then moving down to the second floor, there's a lot more happening down there. We've got our At Me Anything booth, where Team Posh is literally standing by to answer any of your questions about Poshmark, and we also have our info desk for all things PoshFest. The possibilities are endless.
They sure are.
You'll also find a beauty bar for makeup touch-ups, and by popular demand, we've brought our Posh fixings to you live this weekend. We have limited quantities of popular items such as pullovers, wine tumblers, and shipping tape, and a lot more, so make sure you get over there and grab what you want.
Did you say wine tumblers?
Sure did.
I need one of those.
And then as we get ready to move into breakout sessions after lunch, let's quickly talk about how they work, so listen closely. So all of the breakouts are on the first floor except for one. There's one in 207. And there are three time blocks of breakouts happening, so make sure you take a look at that. Pick one session that you want to attend for each time block and go to that. And if there were others that you were interested in, pair up with a PFF and swap some notes so you can get everything that you're interested in. So, yeah.
So before we break, a little birdie told me, speaking of Posh fixings and all, that we're going to do a giveaway for a Posh fixings goodie bag. Who wants to win some Posh fixings?
Yes. So, someone in this audience is about to win. Stand up and look under your chairs. If you have a card under your chair, you are the winner. Where are you?
We're getting the blood moving before lunch.
Wait for it, wait for it. Good opportunity.
Oh, we have a winner!
Congratulations! Take your card to the info desk to claim your prize.
Awesome. All right, so we will see you back here at 3 o'clock. Yeah. So again, for lunch, the first group is going to be 1 through 40. You can go ahead and go to the back. And then there'll be updates for the next couple groups.
So keep your ear open.
All right, enjoy.